of all, none of the strategy is a perfect strategy, including the strategy being shared with by me. So, कोई भी जो strategy होती है वो अपने आप में perfect नहीं होती. So that depends upon many things. That depends upon your level of preparation. Then it depends upon your mindset also. Are you positive or not? Right? And there are different categories of people. Some people who have very well hold over the prelims preparation, right? So there are people who are well prepared, and who are practicing the test. In the test, they are scoring very good marks also. ठीक है? तो उस तरह के लोग भी हैं. Then there are people who are not very well prepared for the prelims, but because of the lockdown and because of the extension of time, they see an opportunity, right? They see an opportunity. Third category of people who are not confident at all, जो बिल्कुल भी confident नहीं है कि सर मुझे चाहे आप 4 महीने दे दो, लेकिन prelims तो मेरा clear होने वाला नहीं है. अगर prelims clear भी हो गया तो mains मेरा clear होने वाला नहीं है. ठीक है? तो हमारे पास में 3 कैटेगरी के लोग होते हैं. ठीक है? सो यू कैन डिसाइड विच कैटेगरी यू बिलोंग टू, राइट? यू कैन डिसाइड विच कैटेगरी यू बिलोंग टू एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन लिसन टू दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन, राइट? अगेन, सिंगल स्ट्रेटजी कैन नॉट वर्क फॉर एवरीवन. दे कैन बी ए ग्रुप ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज, राइट? नाउ फॉर दोज पीपल हु आर वेल प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एंड हु आर स्कोरिंग गुड मार्क्स इन द टेस्ट ऑल्सो, तो उन्होंने मॉक प्रैक्टिस किए, प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन प्रैक्टिस किए, and they got very good marks also. So those people should work on the weak areas of their prelims, and they should keep practicing around 2 mock papers in a week. Theek hai? So they can either choose, they can choose to practice around maybe 50 MCQs on a daily basis, and alternatively they can practice just 2 papers in a week. ठीक है? चाहे तो आप डेली बेस पर 50 एमसीक्यू प्रैक्टिस कर लो, दैट विल बी अराउंड 300 एमसीक्यू, और यू कैन प्रैक्टिस जस्ट 2 फुल पेपर ऑफ द जीएस इन ए वीक एंड कीप रिवाइजिंग योर वीक एरियाज. फॉर एग्जांपल, सम पीपल हैव ज्योग्राफी एज देयर वीक एरिया, एंड नॉट ओनली इट इज नॉट ओनली अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट, इवन विद इन ए सब्जेक्ट देयर कैन बी सम एरियाज. फॉर एग्जांपल, फॉर सम पीपल इनसाइड द इकोनॉमी एक्सटर्नल सेक्टर कैन बी वीक. For some people, inside the CSAT, logical reasoning can be weak, right? So depending upon your own level of preparation, you have to decide which area is weak, and you should work on that area. You can also go for the mains preparation because you have done very well in the prelims, so you deserve some time for the mains also. So आप mains के लिए भी कुछ time लगा सकते हो, उसमें कोई problem आपको नहीं होगी, ठीक है? So for the mains examination, you should spend between 3 to 4 hours, and I will recommend, this is my personal recommendation, right? So based upon my experience, I qualified prelims examination 5 times and I qualified mains examination 3 times. Based on my own experience, I will suggest that you should go for GS paper 2 and GS paper 3 during this time. Why that? That is why, the reason is basically very simple. Because even if we are preparing GS2, GS3, in a way that is contributing to your prelims preparation. So at no point of time you will be feeling uncertain. You will not be feeling guilty that I am not preparing for the prelims, right? So even if UPSC declares that prelims examination is going to happen on 5th of July, right? So उन्होंने बोला था कि हम 5th of June को डेट बताएंगे, and on 5th of June they will require only 30 days. So even if they decide the date of 5th of July, you will not be regretting, right? You will not be wasting your time in the mains. So you should prepare GS2 and GS3, right? For optional paper, GS4 paper, you can wait immediately after the prelims, right? So the time between prelims examination and the result of the prelims examination, theek hai? So 2 mahine ka time aapko milta hai. 2 months you get between the date of prelims exam and the result of the prelims exam. During these two months, you should exclusively prepare 2 areas only, your optional paper and your GS4 paper. and some of the areas of the GS1, for example, world history, Indian society, post-independence, those areas which you did not prepare in the prelims examination, right? So in this way, you can utilize your time in the best possible manner. There are some people who are contacting me, asking me, sir, should I start writing the answers? So if you are in the category one, if you are well prepared, you can start writing two questions on a daily basis. But there should be some kind of evaluation. You should get it evaluated from someone else. It should not be just for the sake of writing, right? So you should always get it evaluated from one of your friend or maybe from one of your senior, or you can avail some paid service from anywhere possible. Okay? So this is how you should proceed. Second category of students who are not prepared at all, who are not prepared well for the prelims, but they are confident that if they get sufficient time, if they get 1.5 month to 2 months, they can crack the prelims examination. In that case, you should focus only and only on the prelims examination. You should leave the mains preparation at all. So mains bilkul nahi karna hai aapko, not at all. Bilkul bhi mains aapko prepare nahi karna hai. Aapko kya karna hai? Basic books prepare karni hai. Lakshmikant, NCERT of geography, right? Spectrum of history. Maybe for the environment, you can go for some standard book or the NCERT, etc. You can solve maximum number of mock, right? Try to solve at least one mock on a daily basis, right? Try to identify your mistakes. So this is how you should proceed. Is tarah se aapko proceed karna hoga, theek hai? You can also solve previous year questions that will give you clarity. That will give you clarity that how you can read the examiner's mindset. ठीक है, तो आपको इस तरह से अप्रोच करना होगा. Those people who are not confident at all, they have to rethink. उनको rethink करना होगा. They have to rethink whether they should appear for the 2020 or not. Because 1 year is very very crucial, right? Don't waste your time just for the sake of writing the examination. If you know that you did not prepare well, you started very late, and you are nowhere close to the examination requirement, then you can drop this year. Like, dropping is also one of the very important, very wise choice which is used by the wise people. Okay? So sometimes not participating in the war is also very very right decision. So participate in the fight at the right time. Okay? Now, I have made you one revision plan for all of you, the foolproof revision plan, right? I am assuming that examination date is 15th of July. ठीक है, 15th of July की examination date होगी, right? Assuming that date, that means we have total how many days? We have 50 days. हमारे पास में कितने days हैं? 50 days हैं. Out of the 50 days, again, I have kept 6 days for the ग्रेस. मैंने 6 days ग्रेस के लिए रख दिए हैं. आई हैव गिवन द प्लान ऑफ ओनली 44 days, राइट? हाउ टू रिवाइज द एंटायर सिलेबस इन द नेक्स्ट 44 days एंड कम विद द फ्लाइंग कलर इन योर प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है, सो दिस प्लान इज फॉर बोथ कैटेगरी ऑफ पीपल, दोज हु आर वेल प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एंड दोज हु नीड मोर टाइम फॉर द प्रीलिम्स बट दे कैन क्वालिफाई द प्रीलिम्स. ठीक है, so how to go about, किस तरह से जाएंगे. And if you request, so अगर आप request करोगे, then I can have I can give you around 30 minutes on a daily basis. We can come on the live class and I can ask you certain questions, or you can share with me your problems which you face on a day to day basis. So this is how you can proceed. इस तरह से आप लोग proceed कर सकते हैं. So let us see what is the plan kya hota hai. So this plan will start tomorrow, that is on 27th of May. Theek hai, 27th of May ko ye plan start hoga. And here you will be dividing your day into five component. In the first component you will be covering one core subject, in the second component you will be covering second core subject, in the third component you will be covering current affairs, in the fourth component you will be covering CSET, ठीक है, and in the fourth, in the fifth component, I am taking some of your classes, for example, this free economy, current affairs, or maybe government schemes, MCQs. So you can spend 1.5 hours for preparing or for attending these classes, ठीक है? So इस तरह से हम लोग proceed कर सकते हैं. इस तरह से हम लोग proceed कर सकते हैं. On like we can have the session like that. For example, one day I will be teaching you current affairs, economy, and next day I will be taking stock of your preparation about the revision plan. How are you moving in your revision plan? ठीक है? So coming back, in the first phase, in this phase we will spend 12 days. This phase will complete on 9th of June. Right, in this phase we will be having 2 days for the revision also. In this phase, in a particular day, we will be reading geography, history, ठीक है, for those people who are well prepared for the prelims examination, they can skip the history part and they can go for the mains preparation, mains GS paper, paper 2, GS paper 3, either or both of them, ठीक है. Then current affairs, economy, and geography, 3 hours daily basis. CSAT only 1.5 hour. You should practice 20 previous year questions, 20 previous year question from 2013 to 2020. And revisionary class, you can attend the classes which I am conducting. In the second phase, we will start on 10th of June. Sorry, yeah, 10th of June. From 10th of June, this will be ending on 22nd of June. So on 22nd of June, we will be completing this. In this plan, in the morning, we will be completing environment. In the second half, polity. Or if you are confident about the polity, you can go for the mains GS2, GS3. And current affairs of environment and science and tech. Again, in the CSAT, 20 previous year questions on a daily basis, you will be practicing it, doing the analysis. ठीक है, तो आप क्या करेंगे, practice करेंगे उसको और उसको analyze करेंगे कि उसमें क्या mistake किया आपने, कौन से concept आपके weak हैं. You will be making the list of your weak concept so that in the next plan we can cover those concept comprehensively. ठीक है, and you will be attending the revisionary classes. The next phase, third phase, will start on 23rd of June and will continue till 2nd July. 2nd July tak continue karega. In this phase, in the morning, you will be studying polity, then economy, then polity plus IR of the current affair. Then you will be practicing CSAT 2 full paper in a week. Theek hai? And in the last phase, which will be ending on 13th of July, we will be again coming together and I will make you, I will make the strategy how to revise the syllabus, not the entire syllabus, but the core areas of the syllabus in these 10 days at least 2 times. ठीक है, तो इस 10 दिन के अंदर हम किस तरह से 2 बार कोर एरियाज को गो थ्रू कर सकते हैं, ये मैं स्ट्रेटजी आपको बताऊंगा. ठीक है, सो इन दिस प्लान ऑफ अराउंड 45 डेज टू 50 डेज, आई हैव ट्राइड दैट यू कवर ईच एंड एवरी एरिया. In the first phase, thoroughly. In the second phase, in the fast forward manner. ठीक है? Now there will be some ground rule. कुछ ground rule रहेंगे जो आपको follow करने होंगे to take maximum advantage of this revision plan. अगर इस revision plan का आपको maximum advantage लेना है, तो आपको कुछ ground rule follow करने होंगे. You should divide your time into 2:1. For example, if you take out 3 hours. For the geography, अगर आप geography के लिए 3 घंटे लेके चलते हो, out of the 3 hours, 2 hours you will be spending for revising, and 1 hour you will be spending for solving the MCQ and analyzing your mistakes. ठीक है, so you will be dividing entire time. You will be dividing your entire time into 2 areas, like out of 3 hours. 2 hours for the revision and 1 hour for the MCQ practice. ठीक है, 1 day, that is Saturday, will be kept solely for the वीकली रिवीजन, सैटरडे को सिर्फ और सिर्फ वीकली रिवीजन होगा। वीक के दौरान जो भी हमने कुछ पढ़ा हम उसको फटाफट से गो थ्रू करेंगे, ठीक है। सो रिवीजन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। तो तीन तरह के लोग, दो तरह के लोग होते हैं, एक होते हैं हार्ड वर्कर और दूसरे होते हैं आपके स्मार्ट वर्कर, ठीक है। सो हार्ड वर्कर दे आर रीडिंग 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 बट नॉट रिवाइजिंग, एंड स्मार्ट वर्कर दे आर रीडिंग प्लस रिवाइजिंग, ठीक है। सो वी विल बी गोइंग थ्रू द रिवीजन साइमल्टेनियसली, वी विल नॉट पोस्टपोन रिवीजन टू द एग्जाम टाइम, ठीक है। वी विल डू द रिवीजन ऑन ए वीकली बेसिस। ऑन संडे यू कैन हैव सेकेंड हाफ फॉर द ब्रेक, यू कैन गिव दिस टाइम फॉर द फैमिली और जस्ट स्लीप और मे बी टॉकिंग टू योर फ्रेंड, वॉचिंग द वेब सीरीज, पाताल लोक, पंचायत, जो भी आपको देखना है देखो, ठीक है। एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, मेक ए रजिस्टर, एक रजिस्टर बनाओ जिसमें आप लोग कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट चीज नोट करोगे, ठीक है। ये रजिस्टर में आपको बोलता हूं that this is your best friend at the time of examination, ठीक है। तो दोस्तों मैं अपने experience से आपको एक बात बताना चाहता हूं, I want to tell you one thing, when you enter into the examination hall, it is not that how much you are prepared, that is not the sole factor which decides how do you perform in the examination hall. What is also equally important is your level of confidence. You are not having any self-doubt. You are 100% confident about your preparation, right? So that confidence does not come automatically, ठीक है? Just मेरे सोचने से कि मैं confident हो जाऊंगा, ये confidence नहीं आता। This confidence comes from some level of working. हमें कुछ काम करना होता है, उस काम करने से confidence आता है। अब वो काम क्या होगा? So basically what we'll be doing, we will be maintaining one register. In that register, we will be maintaining some important notes. अब वो notes क्या होंगे मैं आपको बताता हूं। Yeah, so you will be noting down the tricky concepts. There are some people who feel that they are not able to remember monetary policy tool. So you can write some important points about the monetary policy tool. There are some students who feel difficulty in science and technology. You can write the tricky concepts of the science and technology. Please keep in mind, don't write everything. Just write 10% or 20% of the syllabus. Just 10% or 20% जो आपको बहुत मुश्किल लगता है, जहां पर आपको फोबिया है, ठीक है। जैसे मेरे लिए, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर मी ड्यूरिंग माई प्रिपरेशन इन द ज्योग्राफी देर आर सम एरियाज वेयर आई वॉज नेवर कॉन्फिडेंट, जहां पे मैं चाहे 10 बार भी पढ़ लू लेकिन एग्जाम से पहले अगर मैं उसको एक बार देख के नहीं जाऊंगा तो मुझे हमेशा डर रहता था कि यार मैं एग्जाम में इसको सवाल को गलत ना कर दूं, ठीक है। I was always doubtful about that concept in the examination hall. So I will write it down somewhere in my register, the important point out of that particular concept. ठीक है? So similarly, you can note down the important concept or you can note down the important facts. तो जैसे कि history होता है, history से कुछ important facts note कर सकते हो, ancient history से, modern history से, ठीक है? Now, things to be kept in mind during the next revision. आपको whenever you are reading, you have something in your mind that okay, next time I will be revising this concept without any fail. चाहे कुछ भी हो जाए, मुझे ये particular concept revise करना ही करना है. So you can jot down the name of that concept so that in the next revision you can revise that concept without any failure. And in the third category, you will write down the type of mistake which you are doing while attempting the MCQ. तो जब भी आप MCQ कर रहे हो उस समय आपने किस तरह की गलतियां की, चाहे वो conceptual mistake हो, factual mistake हो, guess करने की mistake हो, choosing the right option, you should write down these mistake at a separate page. This will give you clarity how to utilize your time. So this register is very very important. You must maintain this register. Today only you can buy This register can be simple school notebook type of register. Maintain this register. And in the last 3-4 days, just before the examination, this register will be your guide. You can revise only and only from this register, nothing else. So, क्या होता है कि एग्जाम से दो या तीन दिन पहले, just 2-3 days before the examination, you will have 50 books on your study table and you will be scary that will I be able to solve the questions if this question comes from science and tech? Will be like, how will I revise these entire books? ठीक है, मन करता है कि मैं दो तीन दिन के अंदर सारी books को पूरी बार revise कर लूं. एक मन में डर पैदा हो जाता है, ठीक है, लेकिन यू हैव प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर लास्ट वन ईयर, सो यू शुड नॉट वरी अबाउट रिवाइजिंग ऑल द 50 बुक्स विच आर ऑन योर स्टडी टेबल. रादर व्हाट यू कैन डू, यू कैन पैक दोस 50 बुक्स इन योर ड्रॉअर. आप उसको अलमीरा में पैक कर दो और एक अपना रजिस्टर निकालो. दिस रजिस्टर विल बी हैविंग 100 और 150 पेजेस. इन द लास्ट 2-3 डेज only and only revise that register and you will be feeling super confident, because when you have revised all of your weak areas, when you have revised all the important facts, when you know which kind of mistake you have been doing in the past, then no force in this world can stop you from maximizing the marks in the examination hall. ठीक है, are you getting my friends? This is the plan that you should have in the next 45 days, and these are the ground rule. So in this ground rule, I have taken care of your MCQ revision, your break time, revision time, your revision register, your weak areas, right? Everything I have taken care in this ground rule. ठीक है.